of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who through your only begotten Son have made us a new creation for yourself, grant, we pray, that by your grace we may be found in the likeness of him in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. We are quite confident that if we ask the Son of God for anything, and it is in accordance with his will, he will hear us. And knowing that whatever we may ask, he hears us, we know that we have already been granted what we asked of him. If anybody sees his brother commit a sin that is not a deadly sin, he has only to pray, and God will give life to the sinner, not those who commit a deadly sin, for there is a sin that is death. And I will not say that you must pray about that. Every kind of wrongdoing is a sin, but not all sin is deadly. We know that anyone who has been begotten by God does not sin, because the begotten Son of God protects him, and the evil one does not touch him. We know that we belong to God, but the whole world lies in the power of the evil one. We know too that the Son of God has come and has given us the power to know the true God. We are in the true God, as we are in his Son, Jesus Christ. This is the true God. This is eternal life. Children, be on your guard against false gods. The word of the Lord. The Lord takes the light in his people. Sing a new song to the Lord, his praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel rejoice in its maker. Let Zion's sons exalt in their king. Let them praise his name with dancing and make music with timbrel and harp. For the Lord takes delight in his people. He crowns the poor with salvation. Let the faithful rejoice in their glory, shout for joy and take their rest. Let the praise of God be on their lips. This honor is for all his faithful.
with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus went with his disciples into the Judean countryside and stayed with them there and baptized. At the same time, John was baptizing at Enon near Salim, where there was plenty of water, and people were going there to be baptized. This is before John had been put in prison. Now, some of John's disciples had opened a discussion with a Jew about purification. So they went to John and said, "Rabbi, the man who was with you on the far side of the Jordan, the man to whom you bore witness, is baptizing now, and everyone is going to him." John replied, "A man can lay claim only to what is given him from heaven. You yourselves can bear me out." I said, "I myself am not the Christ. I am the one who has been sent in front of him. The bride is only for the bridegroom, and yet the bridegroom's friend who stands there and listens is glad when he hears the bridegroom's voice. This same joy I feel, and now it is complete. He must grow greater, and I must grow smaller." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Son of God has come and given us the power. The Greek word epiphany is translated into English as manifestation. The term epiphany in the liturgy is used with reference to Jesus being manifested to the wise men, that feast we celebrated a few days ago. He was manifested, that is, he is made known. And these days, immediately after the Epiphany, we celebrate the fashion, the ways in which Jesus is made known to the world at present. And more importantly, how we may, with his help, make Jesus known and manifest him, show his presence in the world to others. It is for this the Son of God has come and given us the power to manifest him by our lives. How has Jesus given us the power? In what way do we show him to the world? Well, first, Jesus has given us the power to know the true God, the God of power, the God of wisdom, the God of love. On Tuesday, I met an old friend, a Baptist, and he was smiling. I said, "I thought you had just been discharged from your job." So he gave a bigger smile and he told me, "God is good. God loves me. When one door closes, he will open another." God, the true God, has made himself known to us. By our acceptance of his will, we manifest him to others. And secondly, we have received the power of prayer. It is something wonderful. We can go to God 24/7 and pray to him. And St. John says, "We are confident that if we ask the Son of God for anything, and it is in accordance with his will, he will hear us." Recently, a professed atheist came to me and asked me to pray for healing. Well, I kind of said to myself, what is an atheist asking for prayer? Well, if they believed in the power of prayer, so should we all the more. And again, St. John tells us, if you see your brother commit a sin, you have only to pray, and God will give life to the sinner. Do we use the power of prayer that Jesus gives us? When we are people of prayer, when we have peace in adversity, we are manifesting the power of Jesus, the presence of Jesus in the world today. In today's gospel, you're told Jesus stayed with his disciples. Jesus stayed with his disciples. When each of us was baptized, Jesus stayed with us through his Holy Spirit and gave us the confidence, gave us the love to share with other people, to share with them, to care for them with joy. It's, I suppose, 59 years ago I was in Nigeria, and when this old Volkswagen, which was breaking down all the time, went to a little abandoned village there and discovered I was lost. So I got out of the makeshift car to ask somebody to help me, and I saw a big fellow approaching me. I was a little bit apprehensive, but he came to me, he said, I am a Catholic, and I am only too happy to help you, which he did. I remember that phrase so well. I am a Catholic. I am only too happy to help you. Is that what we speak and tell strangers or people who are in need? I am a Catholic, so I'm happy to help you. But that's what the gospel tells us today. St. John the Baptist going before Jesus. As the best man is joyful because the groom is coming, we should be joyful when we're preparing the way for the groom, preparing the way for Jesus. We should be so happy. We should be full of rejoicing and looking out for opportunities to help others. So that is the third blessing, the third power that Jesus gives to us, the power of joyful and humble helpfulness. So that is what we pray for today, that we, having received the power from Jesus, will manifest, will make known his goodness and his presence in the world today, by how we pray, how the words we say, and by our actions, and indeed by our own presence as loving people. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand for the prayer of the faithful. Almighty God, we thank you with all our heart that you have manifested your love to us through the presence and continued presence of your only Son, Jesus, through his Holy Spirit, with us every moment of our lives. And so we ask you, Lord, may we use this power that in times of adversity we may be at peace with you, with ourselves, and with others. And that peace of soul that we have in adversity will manifest the confidence all should have in the love and power of Jesus. Lord, hear us. Lord, we thank you, you have given us the power of prayer. The fact that we pray, the fact that we pray with confidence, manifests to others your wisdom and your love. Teach us, Lord, to be people of prayer. Lord, hear us. Lord, through our baptism, your Holy Spirit is with us. Grant it in our actions, in our willingness to help those who need help, and to do so joyfully and humbly, we may make known your own love, Jesus, to everyone in the world today. Lord, hear us. And so, Lord, we pray for all our brethren who are suffering. We pray in particular for our leaders, that they may have the wisdom to follow your guidance in these difficult times. Lord, hear us. We put these prayers and resolutions in the hands of our Blessed Mother Mary as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Grant, O Lord, what we ask of you in the spirit of faith, through Christ our Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery we may be faithfully united in mind and in heart, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. and when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Jason our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and for my divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await a blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace.
The table of the Lord is laden with all that you and I need for our journey. He invites all who hunger and thirst to his table of plenty. And even though you cannot be physically here, still come and receive from our Lord in a spiritual way. Let us pray together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. O Divine Savior, O Jesus, O Blessed Sacrament.
Let us pray. May your people, O Lord, whom you guide and sustain in many ways, experience both now and in the future the remedies which you bestow, that with the needed solace of things that pass away, they may strive with ever deepened trust for things eternal through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.